Today I'm going to show you how to create a flow between Trello and Smartsheet. Then we'll create some tasks and see them sync. And we'll set the priority to low. Actually, let's set it to medium. And we'll add a quick description. And we'll select the list that we want to sync to. Then we'll save our changes and we'll watch it sync over to Trello. We can see that our Smartsheet row had synced over to Trello. It's in the to-do list. It's got our medium label on it, and the description has also updated. Because this is a bi-directional flow, we can actually make changes in the Trello card and have those changes sync back to Smartsheet. So let's update the description. And let's change the label from medium to low. We'll save those changes, and let's also move it over into the doing list. Now that's done, let's watch those changes sync back in Smartsheets. Great. So it looks like all of our changes have synced back into Smartsheet. We can see if we extend our description here that the description has been updated, the priority has been updated, and the list is changed in Smartsheet. Now I'll show you how to set up this flow in Unito. Let's get started. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna connect our tools. We start by selecting the account we wanna connect to, and then selecting the board we want to connect. Likewise for Smartsheet, we select the account, and then we select the specific sheet. If you haven't already connected your account, you'll wanna click on Connect a New Smartsheet Account or Connect a New Trello Account, and then follow the steps on screen to authorize your account. The next step is editing the flow direction. This is where we decide which way we want Unito to create the synced items. For the purpose of this exercise, let's stick to bi-directional sync. That way, items created in either tool will sync to the other. Next, we'll move on to the rules. The rules page is where we decide which specific items in each tool are synced to the other. On the Trello side, we've got a default rule to only sync Trello cards whose status is open to Smartsheet. And because I'm looking to sync every Smartsheet item, I don't have any rules on the Smartsheet side. If you'd like, you can add rules based on the various Smartsheets columns that you've got. This will allow you to filter the specific items you're looking for. Next, we'll move on to the mapped field section. The mapped field section is where we decide which data is actually synced within the items. On the left-hand side, we've got fields from our Trello cards, and on the right-hand side, we've got the columns from Smartsheet. Some of these columns have a cog next to it, and this means that they're drop-down columns, and there are more mapping options available. In this case, I'm mapping specific Trello lists to a drop-down column in Smartsheet. That way, Unito knows exactly which value to sync between each tool. In this case, I'm actually using Trello labels to sync the priority in Smartsheets. So I've also added a drop-down column for that. In the middle, we can select the direction of the flow of information for specific fields. In this case, we're going to keep it bi-directional so that changes made in either tool will sync back to the other. So that's how you connect Trello and Smartsheet with Unito.